Okay, good afternoon, class. So today we're looking at factorization. At this point, we have completed the common factor factorization. So today we're going to look at the second type of factorization, which is examples for exercise 2, which is on page 38. Today's type of factorization is type 2, which is difference of 2 squares. Difference of 2 squares. So how do we know we're going to apply the difference of 2 squares? Firstly, identification, how we would know is that it has only 2 terms. Okay? It has 2 terms. Second step is then, there must be a negative or a minus sign between the two terms. There must be a minus sign between the two terms. Okay. And thirdly, both terms must be squares, or perfect squares. Okay. An example of perfect squares is 1, 4, 9, 16 over 25 and 40. What makes this perfect squares? Or squares? Is that we can take the square root of these numbers. Not so. What's the square root of 1? 1. What's the square root of 4? 2. What's the square root of 9? 3. The square root of 16 over 25? 4 over 5. Square root of 1 over 4? 1 over 2. So these numbers will result in rational values, not so. So these are what we call perfect squares, or squared numbers. If we look at 4a squared, 9x squared, 16x4 over 25 is 6, and 4 into x, or 4 into a minus b all squared. What is the square root of 4a squared? 2a. What's the square root of 9x squared? 3x. What's the square root of 16a4 over 25b6? 4a squared over 5b cubed. What's the square root of 4 into a minus b all squared? What's the square root of 4? 2. What's the square root of b a minus b squared? A minus b. Why? Because if I square this, what is 2 into a minus b times 2 into a minus b? 2 times 2 is 4. A minus b times a minus b is a minus b squared. You guys understand? So these are examples of squares or perfect squares. Alright, you guys understand?
I don't know.
Okay. So let's look at the examples.
Didn't I have a marker here for this page here? No.
So remember, for the identification there were 3. The first one was there were 2 terms. Are there 2 terms?
Yes.
Secondly, there be a negative sign between it. Is there a negative sign between it?
Yes.
And thirdly, it must be squares. What's the square root of x squared?
Yes.
What's the square root of y squared?
Y.
So in other words, this then can be then taken into the difference of
2 squares.
So what is the square root of x squared?
X.
So there goes an x and then 1 gets plus and 1 gets minus. What's the square root of y squared?
1.
There's your answer. And we can test it if you like. You don't have to test. Probably get you extra marks in the exam. But if you got x plus y times x plus x minus 1. What's x times x? X squared. X times minus y? Negative x1. What's y times x? Positive x1. Y times negative y?
Y squared.
Negative y squared. So that cancels, leaves you with x squared minus. You see, it's the same. And as we discussed in our first lesson, that factorization is actually the reverse of products. Okay? Factorization is the reverse of products. So we can test. As addition is the reverse of subtraction, multiplication is the reverse of division. Products, of course, is the reverse of factors. Okay? You guys understand? And as I said, you don't have to always test if that works. Okay? That's the first one. So let's look at number two. I'll give you a chance to do number two quickly. Let's first identify if this is the difference of two squares. Firstly, it must be a two terms. Is that the case?
Yes.
Secondly, minus between it. Is that the case? Yes. Thirdly, both e squares, and in this case, both are squares. Not so. So do that quickly. Why are you guys moving books around again? My girl, I'm talking to you.
I don't take books.
Sorry? So why do you have the book in your hand?
Because
somebody threw it there. I don't know. Okay, you guys finished? Alright, so let's go for it. So first thing is going to be two brackets. What's the square root of 4a all squared? 2a. So there goes 2a and 2a. One must be plus and the other one must be? What's the square root of 9b squared? Okay, and we can test it. What's 4a times 4? 2a times 2a? 4a squared. What's 2a times negative 3b? Negative 6ab. What's positive 3b times 3a? Positive 6ab. And which cancels, not so? And what is positive 3 times positive 3b times negative 3b? Negative 9b squared. Will you guys understand? Is there any confusion there? No. People, if you had gone and you made this minus and this plus, no blame on you, it will be the same answer. Okay, you all agree with that. Why? Because that 4 multiplied by 3 is 12, and 3 multiplied by 4 is also
12.
So you can interchange. Okay? But you always see, we write often the negative in the second bracket. You'll see later on why. Okay? So any questions? No? Go to number 3. So let's identify if this is that case of difference of two squares. Difference of two squares is also known as dots. Okay. Difference of two squares. Can you see that? D-O-T-S. Dots. In case somebody talk about dots and you don't know where they get that from. Well, their maths is cooler than yours. Right. People, is that, you have the two terms?
Yes.
Is there a minus between it?
Yes.
Are both perfect squares?
Yes.
So do that quickly, factorize it. You guys finish?
Yes,
go for the Pumla.
The two brackets.
Two brackets, yes.
3x.
The square root of 9x squared is 3x, yes.
And then a plus and a minus.
Plus and a minus.
On one side it's positive 1 over 2.
So So yes, so the square root of 1 over 4 is 1 over 2. Do you guys understand? Any confusion? Did I tell you what we call these two of each other? The conjugate pairs. I think we spoke about that in further maths, no? Known as the conjugate pair. We got x, k to the exponent 4 minus 1. Let's check if this is the difference of two squares. The first identification point is, are there two terms?
Yes.
Is there a negative between it? Are both perfect squares? So what do we have? What do we get? You get k squared plus 1 k squared. You all agree with that? But what do you see here in the second bracket? Sorry? The square. There's a square in the first bracket as well. Yes, Michael? Positive and negative. You're saying that's going to cancel this out. No, this is being multiplied. If this was added, then it's good. That positive one, negative one would be canceled. But what if I gave you this sum and I asked you to factorize that? Is this two terms? Yes. Not O. Okay. Is it the negative between it?
Yes.
Or is it two squares?
Yes.
So what does that mean? You can factorize this further. Is that the check if this is the case? Is it two terms?
Yes.
Is it the minus between it?
No.
So can I apply the difference of two squares here?
No.
In other words, that will remain k squared plus 1. And that k squared minus 1 can be taken further. Okay, and you'll see now, and that's the reason why I put a negative here. Okay, so that will change while everything on the side remains the same. Okay. So what's the square root of k squared? Okay, so it's k and k, 1 plus the other, minus. What's the square root of 1? So we're always going to factorize as far as possible. See, any confusion there? Okay. The next one, number 5. We've got x squared minus in brackets, you've got m plus n all squared. Let's check if that is the difference of two squares. Is it two terms?
Yes.
Yes. Is there a negative between the two terms?
Yes.
Are both perfect squares?
Yes.
So you all agree that I can apply the difference of two squares. What's the square root of x squared?
X
and? 1 plus the other? What's the square root of m plus n all squared? M plus? You all understand that, no? You all agree with that? Who disagree? What's wrong? Now, always I ask this question around the same mistake many of you are making. What, your hand was up, yes? What's wrong? Okay, yes, Michael? Must be in a bracket. Why must this be in a bracket? Huh? The negative must be multiplied. You all agree with that? Is that what you're saying? Remember that the rule that says is if there's more than one term following a negative sign, let's put this in brackets. So make a note there. If I put a bracket here, it's not going to make any difference to us. Can you see that, people? But if you had written anything, no problem. But this is a common made error here by learners. Okay, they leave this bracket out here. So watch out for that, okay? There's more than one term following a negative sign of the bracket. So we never have a bracket within a bracket here. We're always going to simplify. So what we do is we get rid of this bracket. Again, this bracket is not needed here. So I get x plus m plus n into x minus m minus m. Okay. Let's do it again. Okay. So number 5, we got x squared minus open brackets m plus n all squared. So let's identify if it is the difference of two squares. Are they two terms? Yes, what separates terms? Plus and minus. So yes, it's two terms. Is there a negative between it? Yes. Are both perfect squares? Yes. So what's the square root of x squared? X and x. One plus the other? Minus. What's the square root of m plus n all squared? M plus n. M plus. This we will put a bracket around. Why? Because of the negative. It's more than one term following the negative sign. Let's multiply that in there. Because we don't have brackets within brackets yet. M plus n. X minus m minus. Yes, Michael. You can go straight into this. She's asking, can you move from this straight into here? Yes? But let us just mess up this negative on that end. Just watch it out. Just watch out for that. Okay. So with that, you should now be able to do exercise 2 on page 38. Okay? I'll give you a couple of minutes to complete that exercise. Okay? The full lesson can be found in the description box below.